Welcome to round one of the Intercontinental Rally Challenge 2012, the Santa Rally Azores, first of 13 rallies with a challenging mix of gravel and tarmac rounds, ending once again in Cyprus this year. Based in São Miguel, the largest of the nine islands that make up this Portuguese-speaking archipelago, the Azores marks the first gravel round of the season, totaling 14 stages over a competitive distance of 198 kilometres. Yes, the event centred on Ponta Delgada. São Miguel's largest town, southwest of the island, service park headquarters there permanently. The archipelago of the Azores is composed of nine volcanic islands situated in the middle of the North Atlantic Ocean and is located about 1,500 kilometres west of Lisbon and about 3,900 east of the North American coast. So, time to go round once more. Defending champion Andreas Mikkelsen stayed with Škoda UK for this season. Yes, good competition, terrific pace after contesting some rallies during the winter time as well. He comes here, well, just as keen as ever. Johanen won the Azores last year, beating Mikkelsen, became the 2011 world champion in S2000 and was IRC champion in 2010, let's not forget. A quality list including Brian Bouffier had an impressive IRC campaign in 2011, winning the IRC Monte Carlo, you may remember. Challenged for the title all season long, finally ended sixth in the championship. You want fortune? Well, bad luck seems to follow Bruno Magalhães. He's back though, joins Bouffier in the Italian Delta Rally team, won the Azores in 2008 and 10, and now, well, he's back after not driving competitively for 5 months. Last gravel rally was the Azores last year, I might add. Hermann Gassner Jr. ended fifth in 2011 on the SWRC. German rally champion in 2009. He's backed by Red Bull, so he's got the livery and indeed the pace. Sepp Weigand of Skoda Germany, 21 years of age. Started rallying in 2010. He's a hot ship. Three stages on day one of the Azores rally. Stage two had to be shortened due to very bad road conditions on the second part of the stage. Well, getting ready for the very first stage then of the IRC 2012. Weather dry with some muddy spots on the stage due to rain, and indeed rain forecasts intermittently throughout the rally. 8.25 kilometres in total. Getting underway just around about 2:30 local time. Caroa da Mata then, and underway, soft Michelin compound tyres with one spare for Andreas Mikkelsen and his Skoda Fabia S2000. Well, puncture at the front left, but thankfully for him, very close to the finish, so still with the fastest time on stage. That's the way to ride your luck. Johanen first on the road, cleaning it a little, but has an advantage on these muddy tracks. As you can see, they were likely to cut up big time later on. Soft compound suited him well. Second fastest, 3.2 seconds behind Mikkelsen. And what of Brian Bouffier? Hard compound Michelin tyre for him. Well, wasn't a good choice. Bad grip on the stage, lacking rhythm as well. Off the pace, third fastest, 10.1 seconds behind Mikkelsen. And that's a big gap. What about Bruno? Hadn't been rallying for 5 months. Thought he was flying on the stage, but at the end, very confused by his slow time. 5.7 seconds behind his Peugeot teammate Bouffier, and down 15.8 on Mikkelsen. Wasn't what he wanted. So on to stage two. Zao Brás and Vila Franca, 6 kilometres only. And just past 3 p.m. in the afternoon, you won't be able to tell much time-wise with the leaden skies. Mikkelsen found a shortcut on the stage, goes off to the left, cuts the road, and the simulcam will tell us if Mikkelsen gained time by making that cut. Well, before cutting the road, Mikkelsen is behind Hannanen, and then all of a sudden Mickelson is back on Hannan's tail once again. Cheeky idea, and why not? We've seen it before. Hannan fastest on the stage, Mickelson leading the rally though by 1.2 seconds. Well, day three ending with the Group Marks Super Special featuring that jump. Mickelson fastest. Yes, I think we saw enough of that jump. Mickelson then heading Hannan by 1.4 seconds at this stage, with Bouffier 23 adrift, Megalesh still in touch, just shy of the 30-second mark. So, day one, that's how it finished. Weather conditions, though, getting worse on day two. Been raining overnight. Six stages on day two, including the famous Sete Ciudades near the volcano, although shrouded in cloud at the peak, so it wasn't quite as dramatic looking as it actually is to drive through. So Sete Ciudades, 23.97 kilometres, and just after 20 past 10 in the morning as we got underway. Stage 5 then, the most beautiful of the rally. How much we would see? Well, we were waiting to see, and I have to tell you, it wasn't much. Longest stage of the rally then, very muddy, some fog, and Juha Hannanen got himself into bother. 3.2 seconds behind Mickelson at the start of the stage. Fast section, lost his Skoda. Yes, a lot of backwards and forwards in before getting back underway.
I passed on the last downhill before the finish and need to reverse a few times and in the very fast section, so I lost quite a lot of time over there. Not good.
Hannanen losing 10.4 seconds to Mickelson. So now have a lead of 13.6 going into the midday service. Not bad. There's that dramatic peak I was telling you about. Lost in fog, I'm afraid. Well, after the service at Ponta Delgada, onto stage 6 then. Second run of the stage. Less mud than during the first run. Just as challenging. Frateras, 7 kilometres long, and just a few minutes before 1 in the afternoon is when we got underway. Big dip in the middle, a big climb to finish. Well, Bruno Magalhães changed the setup of his Delta Rally Peugeot. Had a hot moment on the previous stage, and then this heavy, heavy impact. As you can see, the fans were scattering. Magalhães rolling his car. Now, this is a man who's been challenged by funding issues. Goodness me. Stay safe, people. Bruno and his co-driver, Carlos, not injured, but the car effectively destroyed. Winner in 2008 and 2010, had to retire on stage 6, was fourth overall after stage 5. A real shame for Magalhães. Hope he finds the funding and the will to come back.
We have changed before the stage a little bit our setup with the anti-roll bar. The car was moving a little bit. I made a corner completely flat out in fifth gear. I passed to sixth gear because I thought everything was under control. But unfortunately, it was a rock hidden in the left side, and the rear left wheel touching the rock and happens.
It does happen. Stage 7 then, Sete Ciudades, second run through, 23.97 kilometres. Bad weather near the volcano, heavy rain, low clouds, miserable. Yes, finally another fastest time for Hannanen. His first stage win on the day, second on the rally, beats Mickelson with the by the narrowest of margins, 0.1 seconds. Mickelson still in the lead though overall, Hannanen 15.4 seconds behind. Sepp Weigand, the German, first on the road all day, fighting against his compatriot Gassner in the Battle of the Germans, and was fastest than Gassner on the previous stage, and again beating his compatriot, but only by 0.3 seconds. Hermann Gassner Jr., 0.3 behind Weigand on the stage, as we've told you. And overall, Gasnet fifth, just 0.8 seconds behind Weigand, who's fourth. Well, the conditions just became so bad, the organisers were forced to cancel Stage 8, just too much water about. And as you can see, the spectators were having just as much trouble, even at slow speeds, as the rest of us. Very difficult to get in and out, and certainly not safe. Well, those difficult weather conditions continued on to Stage 9. How about this for the 4-0 car? Oh dear. Calbras to Villafranca, 16.18 kilometres, and just after 4 p.m. in the afternoon. A lot of water at the very beginning of the stage. Horrible muddy parts. Well, the security car span on stage. There were to be others that followed, I have to tell you. So the final stage of day two, Alexander Salyuk of the Ukraine in the M-Sport Fiesta. Fiesta means party. Wasn't enjoying it. Yes, Dream Team Ukraine's Oleksandr. Horrible run on the stage, spinning. Big water splash, stalls the engine later in the stage. Bit of body work as souvenirs for everybody. Seventh overall after day two. Downward turn to his mouth, I think. Andreas Mikkelsen, fastest again. Fastest on six of the nine stages to this point, and leading with 16.2 seconds. Quite a margin in the overall classification over the likes of Johan.
Everything is very good. This stage is very, very much water in the start. It was aquaplaning like H-E-L-L.
Don't need too much spelling to work that one out. Mikkelsen then leading Hannanen by 16.2. Bouffier, a minute and 17 down, and then just look at the gaps fall away in the battle of the Germans. Yes, they're off the leading pace though. That was all for days one and two in the 2012 Azores Rally. Another five stages remaining for the final day. And we'll be back with a roundup after this. Welcome back. Good afternoon, nice. That's the place, it's not a welcome. 19.6 kilometres and just heading for 10 a.m. local time for the last day. At the first stage of day three in the eastern part of the island, sun is back. Thank goodness for that. Yes, the terrible weather, just a thing of the past, and some of the tropical plants, and yes, the mists have lifted, thank heaven. Well, first on the road, again, said to be pretty decent condition. A lot of loose gravel. How would Sepp Weigand go on this one? Ah, sunshine, phenomenal. Yes, it does blow in across the Atlantic, those storms, but quickly dissipate as well. As you can see, not much large tree life at this part of the island, because the winds do blow. That's why there's a wind farm here, but benign and resting at the moment. Unlike Sepp Weigand, fourth quickest, moving into fourth in the standings. Hermann Gassner Jr. stalling his engine on the stage, said it was just a bit too quick for him. Pushing hard on the next one, I think. Losing 11 seconds to Weigand, though. Dropping to fifth overall. Weigand fourth again with a gap of only 1.4 seconds, though, between the two Germans. Still close. Brian Bouffier, little mistake. Had to use his reverse. Just couldn't follow the rhythm, or indeed the match the pace of Hannanen or Mikkelsen. Third quickest on the stage. Once again, kind of bedding into that position, and indeed comfortable, you might say, for a podium place in the standings. Johannen, well, what does he do but push hard? Said he couldn't go much faster without taking ridiculous risks, and his time of 14.07.4 looked to be a good one. And Andreas Mikkelsen in his pomp at the moment. First stage of day three. And guess what? Stretching his lead over Hannanen to 17.9 seconds. Said it was a fantastic stage. Perfect driving conditions. Sunny as well. Hey, why not? Stage 11. Tronchera. 22.02 kilometres in total. Just around about 10:45 in the morning. Bright weather